Did you know that DNA from your hair and your blood can be used to make something like this called a DNA fingerprint? Hi, I'm Janice Creneti, and I'm here to talk to you about how restriction enzymes work. They're actually an important part of this process. An enzyme is a chemical, a protein, in your body that helps make reactions go. You can kind of think of it like stepping on the gas pedal in your car. Well, DNA is the material in your body that makes you you. And DNA is unique from one person to the next. In fact, the only people that have identical DNA would be identical twins. So scientists can take your DNA and they can make something called a fingerprint, which basically would show that you are you and nobody else. But in order to do that, they have to use something called restriction enzymes. Restriction enzymes have the job of actually cutting the DNA into little pieces. Here's how it works. The restriction enzyme, and there's hundreds of them in your body, we're going to talk about one called EcoRI, which is commonly used in the making of the DNA fingerprint. They look along the DNA strand, and they look for certain sequences. This one looks for something called GAATTC, and it cuts right between the G and the A. Those are nucleotide bases in your DNA strand. Every time it finds that sequence, it's going to cut it, creating different sizes sequences. Well, you can see these are all different sizes. When electricity is applied to them, they actually travel different lengths, with the shortest ones traveling the farthest, and the heaviest ones not traveling so far. That's what creates the bands in your DNA fingerprint, helping to figure out who you are. I'm Janice Creneti, and this is How Restriction Enzymes Work.